This video was made possible by Wix. If you're ready to create a website, head over to wix.com/go/infographics to try out one of their premium plans right now. Laika, a stray dog that was rescued from the streets of Moscow, was strapped into Sputnik 2 and blasted into outer space in 1957. And ever since that 1957 spaceflight, dogs have been at the forefront of many scientific experiments. Now, these loyal, compassionate, and understanding friends are even helping out man in the afterlife. Yes, indeed, dogs are now venturing out into territories unknown and returning back to wag their tails. In a series of experiments at the University of Pittsburgh, scientists have successfully brought otherwise healthy dogs into a state of stone-cold, clinical death, only to return them to life. This breakthrough may point to the way forward for humans to take smaller trips to zombie land in the near future. Today, on the Infographics Show, we'll take a look at just that: why scientists created zombie dogs. So why, oh why, does a team of highly educated and morally sound men and women purposefully kill man's best friends, as we all know dogs are, and then attempt to reanimate them? Today, we'll find out. The team of scientists at the Safer Center for Resuscitation Research simply took the dogs and flushed their bodies of blood and replaced the blood with a cool saline solution laced with oxygen and glucose. Once the fluids were switched, the dogs swiftly entered cardiac arrest and whimpered. Their hearts stopped beating, and their tails stopped wagging, and they were, for all intents and purposes, clinically stone dead. But it wasn't all over for Rover, not by a long shot. The dogs remained in a state of suspended animation. Technically brain dead, our furry friends would not have experienced any pain and would have, experts think, no conscious memory of this transitional stage. After a period of 3 hours, the experiment was now reversed with the team removing the saline solution and reintroducing the blood back into the hounds. Then, using an electric pulse, the dogs' hearts were jump-started back to life. The majority of dogs returned back to life in full command of their canine faculties. Their eyes opened, their noses twitched, and their tails wagged once more. According to the research reports, there was no evidence of brain damage. But all did not go swimmingly for the researchers at the Safer Center for Resuscitation Research. Howls of protest from animal rights activists were hurled at them. These objections were dampened by a statement from the research center outlining the research techniques and clarifying that the dog zombie experiment was in compliance with ordinary standards for the ethical treatment of animals in the name of science. Like the good Lord, the scientists had taken life away and then given it back to animals in this bizarre experiment. But why kill a bunch of dogs and bring them back to life? Nope, this wasn't research for a new zombie movie. And no, the researchers weren't just curious to see if the experiment would actually work. No, it was nothing that extreme. We're pleased to report the zombie dog experiments were all for the good of medical science and may someday save your life. But how can turning out the lights on innocent puppies and then reviving them help us human beings? Well, imagine, if you will, that you're in a car crash. You have flown through the front windshield and have suffered severe injuries that cause you to lose blood fast. The hospital receives an emergency call and sends out an ambulance. They arrive on the scene and see a road crash victim losing blood quickly. They load you into the ambulance and rush you to the emergency room at the hospital. Once in the emergency room, the doctors have only a certain amount of time before you, the patient, simply dies on the operating table. Now think back to those zombie dog experiments. If the patient's blood could be replaced with another fluid, such as saline, and the patient could be patched up, he or she may have a better chance of survival. Surgeons will then have 3 hours to operate, find the correct blood type, and bring the crash victim back to life. One day, the team will extend their experiments to human subjects who have been admitted to emergency rooms and are losing blood fast. Those zombie dogs lost their lives briefly so that maybe we can save thousands of human lives in the future. Thus, the reason the team of scientists has created zombie dogs and reanimated them following hours of clinical death is so that they can use the same technique to revive human patients in emergency situations. I'll think that you agree that this is a pretty neat idea. The zombie dog experiments prove that bodily tissue and blood vessels can be surgically repaired after a period of hours. These tests have shown that the dogs recover normally with no brain damage, which provides us with valuable knowledge about how consciousness functions. The team at Pittsburgh are essentially modern-day Victor Frankensteins, albeit with dogs. For years, scientists have relentlessly attempted to discover new ways to bring people back from the dead to solve scientific mysteries. Once our hearts stop ticking and our brain stops functioning, is life really over? Mary Shelley's Frankenstein is a timeless story precisely because it taps into human curiosity in regards to the two most puzzling of questions. Could there be life after death? And is death really the end? The desire to reanimate animals has a long and colorful history going back to the 18th century. Danish physician and veterinarian Peter Abelgul resuscitated chickens using electricity way back in 1775. Dr. Abelgul, according to his antiquated research, succeeded in first killing chickens by means of an electric shock and then reviving them by a countershock of electricity applied to the breast. Long career includes significant contributions to medicine, biology, zoology, botany, physics, chemistry, and mineralogy. He might possibly have been one of the first to have successfully reanimated animal life almost 250 years before the zombie dog experiments took place. However, as far as promising research for the reanimation of human life goes, the dog experiments paved the way forward for further studies. Zombie dogs may help us extend human life, but Wix ensures your website will live forever and look great the entire time. With over 500 fully customizable and ready-to-use templates, as well as robust design tools for making your own, Wix has everything you need to make a great-looking site. And with full support for mobile platforms and live assistance available, your website will always be live and ready no matter the device. Click the link in the description or go to wix.com/go/infographics and check out how Wix can help make your website the website of your dreams. So what do you think about the zombie dog experiment? Do you think the research was immoral? Or do you think such research could be extended to include human subjects? Would you take part in such an experiment for $1 million? There's risk associated with all scientific research. Should we even bother trying to extend human life? Let us know in the comments. Also, be sure to watch our other video called Why Are We Afraid of Friday the 13th and the Number 13? Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.